Now for more on the massive oil spill in Oriental Mindoro, we are joined by Governor Umerlito Dolor. Good afternoon, Governor Dolor, and welcome to Dateline Philippines.
Good afternoon, Dar.
Yes, it's good to have you here. Now, we've been receiving reports that the area that's been affected by the massive oil spill is becoming wider. Now, based on the last reports that you received, how many areas, perhaps in terms of barangays or towns, are now affected by the oil spill?
From the first report 2 days ago, that's three towns. Now it's up to eight towns already, stretching from Nauhan, the coastal barangays, and the coastal waters of Nauhan, Pola, Pinamalayan, portion of Gloria, Mansut, Bungapo, Rohat. And now, as of this morning, it's now at Mantalay.
That's
the second to the farthest most coastal town of Oriental Mindoro.
All right. Can you describe to us the degree of affectation or the degree of the effect of the oil spill in particular towns? Because some, I think, are having it worse than the others.
Yeah, particularly in the town of Pola, the oil spill has already reached the shoreline.
Okay.
Particularly in the barangays of Buhaynatubig, Kalima, and Pakawan.
Okay.
For the other towns, they are still at the scene, but the smell can be smell already at the coastal areas.
Okay.
And our fisher folks have been advised not to travel to these areas because of the danger, but water contamination, and at the same time, the possibility that they might contract illnesses.
Okay. Government Dolor, by saying that it has reached the shoreline of these specific barangays, that effectively puts their livelihood on hold. What is the advice to fishermen in these areas, especially that those that depend on fishing in the affected area?
Yeah. We have already advised them first and foremost to stop going to these areas. We have coordinated the Department of Social Welfare and Development, our provincial agriculture office, our social care office. Before, they were now preparing first the distribution of food packs to all of these affected fisher folks. After the food packs, I have discussed with Secretary Rexy this morning the possibility of giving aid in crisis situation or aid, the possible financial assistance for those families that are affected with their livelihood.
Okay, when you talk about financial assistance, this could mean resources coming from the government, and the question would be, do you have access to these resources, or do you see that at some point you would have to declare a state of calamity in your province?
Yeah, we are proposing after the assessment to be conducted by the agriculture of the extent of damage, to declare the province under state of calamity on Monday.
Okay.
And with the assurance of Secretary Gatsalian that with or without the declaration of state of calamity, they will assist because there is a calamity.
Okay. Aside from that, what kind of help are you getting now from the national government and from the other agencies that should be there to see this through, particularly the Philippine Coast Guard, maybe even the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, because we're talking about marine sanctuaries that are already affected by the oil spill?
Yeah. Department of Environment and Natural Resources Secretary Luis Aga is in Mindoro right now. He has inspected the area by air and had a briefing with the local incident command center, which I put up 2 days ago. After that, he's now in Pola. They're closely monitoring. They're helping us also with the test. PCG, Philippine Coast Guard, is there 24/7.
Okay.
And PFAR is also there. DSW is there. The leaders is Department of Health, together with our regional office and the central office. The toxicologist was there also. We had a meeting just 2 hours ago for the possible airborne and those sickness or diseases that will be illnesses that will be that might be brought by the oil spill.
Okay.
And they have volunteered to conduct the water sample and the air samples to be brought to the facilities at the East Avenue Medical Center.
Okay. So when do we expect, Governor? When do we expect results from these toxicology tests to be out?
They said it's 7 days. That I'm mistaken.
Okay. Okay, so that's 7 days. Now, we know for a fact that this situation comes at a time when Mindoro is expecting a lot of tourist arrivals also for the summer. Are there tourist spots that are already affected by the oil spill, resorts perhaps?
There will be tourist spots which will be definitely affected, potentially to be affected in the event that the oil spill reached the coast.
Okay.
That's why we are doing our best to contain the oil spill at that sea.
All right. Now, the owners of the ship involved in this spill has spoken to media, has expressed its interest, its response to this. They say they will cooperate with any investigation and even in the cleanup efforts. Are you seeing this now? I mean, have you spoken with any of the representatives of the company which owns the tanker?
Immediately after the incident, the following day, I have talked to the representative, the chief's daughter, or very close relative of the company.
Okay.
She assured us of 100% full cooperation. When we discussed the possible compensation, they have assured us that there is an insurance that will handle possible compensation in the future.
Okay.
So I am happy that they're cooperating.
Okay, but do you see them now? Because first things first, I think the first order of battle would be containing the oil spill that they should be heavily involved in as well.
Yes, there is. They are very in close coordination. They are very much in close coordination with our incident command and with our Philippine Coast Guard.
Okay. Just for the record, Governor Dolora, we spoke about 8 barangays or even towns affected by the oil spill. Do we have an estimate on as to the number of people, actual number of people, or perhaps even families affected by the oil spill?
The potential effects of the oil spill might reach up to 3,000 to 4,000 families initially. But now the Provincial Social Welfare Office is consolidating the data from all the municipalities. We just had a meeting at 9 o'clock this morning, tasked the PSWD to identify the affected families because after the finalization of the list, PSWD and the province will be distributing food stamps.
Okay, do you think evacuation is possible? At this juncture,
for now, it's not yet being done because the priority now is to contain the oil spill within the sea. But we have already instructed our incident command center to put up yellow line so that the people will be warned not to go to beaches anymore. To the same.
All right. Do you have an estimate, perhaps, on the economic ramifications or the cost of damage brought about by this situation?
As of now, there is none.
All right.
They're already consolidating the potential damages.
All right. Lastly, what is your advice to the public, particularly those residents affected by this?
Please stay away from the sea, stay away from the shores. Please cover your noses every time you can smell something that is like the odor of the diesel or oil. Do not touch anything that is unusual or unfamiliar. And as of now, please refrain from eating marine products which might come from that area affected by the oil spill.
All right. On that note, Oriental Mindoro Governor Humerlito Dolor, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. We wish you luck with your efforts.
Thank you very much, sir. Good afternoon.